things going on. But what we was doing, though we didn't have it, Santana, we walked like we had it. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Anybody ever been there, man?
Yeah.
You get out there, man, you walk like you got it.
Yeah.
You might not have a dime in your pocket,
right,
but you get up, you press them jeans, man, you get some hot water, because you didn't have to buy the store. So you get that hot water in there, and you put it in there, and I'd be stinking. Then when you come out there, you get your little shoe polish. When you step out there, you walk like you got it. What you saying this morning, Pastor? You got to walk in your authority. Y'all gonna make me out drink by myself, amen. Just because it's a rainy day and some folks tired and sleeping, there's some things that we need from God. And we ain't got no time to wait. Y'all ain't gonna help me. You got to walk like you already got it. Huh? Sometimes we live in a world we walk out there as broke as can be. But looking like you own the bank. Anybody ever been there? Look like you own the bank. What you saying, Pastor? Don't you know, amen, that if you believe God, that you can step out there with nothing and drive back from your brand new car? You ain't gonna make me shout inside this way. I don't see God do it. Well, I feel like having a church by myself. I'm already mad at the devil. I'm already believing some of God that has for me already, because we've got access. Somebody say access. Because he wants to be the one that acknowledge that got you what you got.
Yes.
Can I get the witness inside this place?
Yes.
Somebody shout hallelujah. Yes. Let me say that one more time, amen. You've got to put on the best dress you got.
Yes.
Amen. See, when we come to God, the Bible says we first must believe before we come to Him.
Yes.
Some folks come to God, Lord Jesus, what am I going to do? You can't get nothing from God like that. The Bible said he that come to God must first believe, and believe he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You got to first believe that God already do it. Moaning, crying, and dragging, and well, Lord, maybe you will, and you don't, I understand. No, you've got to go to God, amen, with a made up mind already. Come on, shout amen.
Amen.
Because when I didn't have it, when I was broke, amen, when I had $2-3, amen, but I walk in authority like I owned the bank.
Amen.
Somebody shout glory to
God.
See, we don't walk with our head down. Because if you are a child of God,
yeah,
with one hand in your pocket with your head up, you always hold your head up because you walk in authority. You walk in a place, the devil know who you are. Because you walking in authority. But when I see, we have to walk in it by faith. And by walking in faith, God gave it to us. Does anybody hear what I'm saying this morning? Let me say it one more time, amen. When I started with $2-3. But I kept walking, believing God that I already had it. What you saying, Pastor Mingo? What I'm saying, were you able to go buy a brand new suit? No. But I want to help somebody here through the power of the Holy Ghost. We would go to some garage sales. Y'all ain't going to help me get excited. I got duck head shirts, polo shirts, all kinds of shirts, amen. Dollar shirt.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody knew it but me and Jesus, and I gave him the praise.
Amen. Yeah.
We starch up that polo, start them jeans down. Y'all ain't going to help me get excited.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I walked, amen, with polo. I walked, amen, with Star Jean, and ain't had but a $2 or $3. But I was walking because I was on my way to destiny.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't gonna help me get inside. I was walking in, amen, on my way to destiny with my garage sale shoes on, my garage sale pants on. But I was already walking to something I already seen that I was going to get. Y'all ain't gonna help me. I was already walking to my destiny, amen, that I wasn't going to always be walking, amen, without. But amen, but I kept on walking in destiny until I got, amen, the thing that God has. And I'm still walking because now there's greater things he has.
Amen.
Come on, shout amen.
Amen.
But it was through our sowing and our giving. Even in our finances, God understands, you got this, do that, do.
challenge God and watch God move.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? The Bible said, amen, that God is not a man that he should lie.
Never.
Neither is he the son of man that he has to repent. If God said it, then we got to believe what the word of God says.
Amen.
Come on, shout amen.
Amen.
We gave our tithes, we gave our offering faithfully to God. Amen. Because I knew that if the word of God said it, if God spoke that, amen, he could not lie.
Never.
So when I walked in my authority, I already knew, amen, because he said it in his word, amen, that he would open up the windows of heaven. You can say what you want, amen, this morning. I'm telling you what the word of God, look in the book of Malachi, man, starting from 3 to 6 chapter. Read it for yourself and see for yourself what God says about when you give to God, amen. That how he promised to open up the windows of heaven. We had 6 kids, and I say this every Sunday, that's my testimony of where we come from.
Mm-hmm.
We came from a mighty long way. But as we continue to give God his in a life that's pleasing to God, saints of God, as I stand before your presence this morning, amen. The favor of God, God does not lie. He will cause doors to be opened in your life through obedience to God. When you give to God, not to the pastor. Amen. Not to the first lady, amen. But when you give to God, He will open doors up, amen. That's what God will do. We bought a house, an acre and a half of land. Bad credit, no money. Somebody say bad credit.
Bad credit.
And no money.
No money.
That I've come to the conclusion now, understanding now, church, that when we going through something, no, you getting ready to get your blessing.
Come on, man.
Huh?
Amen.
Some folks say, man, want to go cry and have a misery party, have a crying party. It's just nobody understand what I'm going through, God. But you've got to realize one thing. Somebody, amen. Somebody getting ready to get blessed in this place this morning. God has already provided it for us, church.
Right.
But if we know what the word of God says, amen, that if we stand upon the word, that while you are going through whatever you're going through, he already knows.
Yes.
He just wants you to have the faith to believe that he's going to bring you through no matter how it looks. The longer you start complaining, the more you start crying and get on that telephone and call everybody you can think of, the longer you're going to be in that trial. So when you are encountered with that, amen, what you've got to start doing is that's why you're going through something. Some people are, hallelujah, I thank God, amen, what I just got. But we got to start thanking him sometime before we even get it. Thank you.
In advance.
Okay, if you have your Bibles, go with me to the 54th chapter of Isaiah. Isaiah 54, verse 17. It reads, in the 17th verse, it says, no weapon that is formed, somebody say formed. Against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, said the Lord. Now look what he says again in the first verse. He said that no weapon that is formed. See, in order for the enemy to first come against you, he's got to first have a plot. He's always gonna try to make somebody start talking about you. He's gonna use somebody to try to come against you to start speaking negative words that's only going to be able to make you start doubting what God is doing.
Amen.
Now look what he says, amen. He said that no weapon, what is a weapon? Some folks think a weapon just a gun or a knife, but a weapon could be somebody's mouth that they're putting on you.
Amen.
But he's only forming something. See, they don't know if they will stand on the promises of God's word.
Hallelujah.
What they making their blood pressure go high. They're getting themselves all stressed out behind what folks is saying. Folks will talk about you. Especially when you say you love Jesus, oh, I love the Lord. He heard my cry. Come on, say God. Come on, say God. I love Jesus. But see, what happens is, amen, that when we are getting nearer and nearer to what we are believing God for, the devil ain't gonna come mess with you if he already got you going to doing what he wants you to do. If he know that you're doing what he wants you to do, he ain't gonna bother you. But I've learned, according to the word, that when the enemy start coming against you, it's for a reason, because you are getting ready, amen, to get what God has for you. Here she comes. Well, Pastor, you know they praying against me. What do you mean? Well, Pastor, you know I'm going through this. Well, Pastor, you know my mother-in-law, my ex-mother-in-law, the one couldn't stand it. I know it's us doing it every time. I woke up this morning, they had salt around my porch. And I got up by the trash can, they had all my dead rabbit legs by the back door. I mean, wait a minute, sister. Hold on. Wait a minute. The Bible said, like, you say you love Jesus. Well, I love the Lord. I love the Lord. But you believe in what people say rather than what God says. If you start speaking what the word of God says, amen, you will have whatsoever you ask. If you believe God. If our life is lining up with the word of God, amen, we have access to the kingdom.
That's
the thing that pertains right here as well. Some folks get so caught up because you know why? It's they don't have enough word inside of them.
That's right.
That's why I tell them that. Come to Bible study so you can learn what the word of God says.
That's it right there.
Pastor, can I talk to you? You know they saying all kind of stuff about you. They don't like Solomon. Brother,
big deal.
Because we start rejoicing in that, because we know if they talk about Jesus. Come to the best above the prince. The prince of the devil, say that. What are they going to say about us? All God wants to do is have a vessel that he can use, say that. That his name might be glorified. So he said that no weapon. Because if you a child of God, you're going to be put through the test. If you a child of God, you're going to be put through the test. I'm tired of living like this. I want to better my life. I want things to start working for me. God does too. But the minute that we start, amen, giving into what the devil wants, see, the only way that something can go wrong is if you start complaining and start speaking it out your mouth. Because God cannot move if you speak in doubt.
Come on now.
You operate in doubt. God does not operate in doubt. I don't care if your light bill turned off. I don't care if you ran out of gas. You ain't got no insurance on your car. He's not going to operate in doubt.
That's right.
That's it. That's
you got to believe God no matter what.
Yes.
No matter how it looks.
All on it. Right.
So what the devil does, only thing he can do is form something. What he does, he makes you see a Mariah. Something that looks real, but it's not real. That's what it does. If he can get you to believe what you see, something that don't exist, then he start taking down your faith in God.
Break you down.
Break you down, glory.
Break down. Break down.
But the Bible says, break amen, down. In that first verse again, of the 17th chapter, 54, the 17th verse, he said that no weapon that is formed against thee, against you, against me, shall prosper. What does prosper does? Prosper means to overtake something. Prosper means to receive something or to advance yourself into something. Amen. So he says, amen, that it won't prosper.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
But it's going to go to nothing.
Yeah.
Because all God is trying to do is challenge your faith to see whether you're going to trust the word of God or you're going to believe what some folks say about you.
Go ahead. Say that.
That folk call me lazy. Oh, how you talking about starting a business? Yeah, you're yeah, out there working somewhere. Now you're talking about a business. Yeah, God got to give him a business.
Yeah, yeah.
He just lazy and don't want to work.
Uh-huh.
We have to make up in our mind and know that if God said it.
Yeah.
We have to point out and, single out what people were saying. Because if you listen to folks, amen, they'll keep you in the rut. If you listen to what people say, they'll keep you broke. If you listen to what people say, they'll keep you in power. They're like crabs in a bucket. Every time you try to come up, they'll bring you back down. What the enemy does, he'll use the one that's right close to you,
yes,
and make you start feeling like it must be God.
Wait,
yes.
That God don't want me to have this.
Come on now.
Because any time that you can start speaking just a little bit of doubt, and give the enemy an inch to come in of what you believe in God for, he'll start making you doubt God.
Yeah.
He'll start making you settle for less.
Yeah,
he'll start making you believe that's where God wants you to stay.
Right.
Amen. Because he's making you go through what you're going through.
Yeah.
But every time I look, God, look like every time I stay broke. Every time I make money, but it go for every bill. I ain't got a dime left over.
That's right.
Because you
start really speaking. Come
on now.
You got to get your mind.
See?
You got to get your lips, amen, to a place where it's drilled inside.
Yeah,
amen. It's prosperous. When I speak the word, it's prosperous. Even though it might not look like it, I speak to it anyway.
Yeah.
Didn't you hear what I said? I said, didn't you hear what I said?
Go ahead.
It's not the word. I said, God said, all things are possible to him that believes. Like you hear it. I'm telling you what the word says. You told me what you believe. I'm telling you what I believe according to the word. I just told you that it's not going to work. Maybe you didn't understand the word that's coming out of my mouth. Let's go over this again. I said the word of God tells me. Mark chapter 11, verse 24. That if I have much faith as a grain of mustard seed, I can speak to the mountain out of my mouth, and that mountain is going to be removed. Don't shout hallelujah. What's that mountain after? That mountain can be anything that's in my way. Amen. Anything that's trying to block me. Anything that's trying to stop me. I speak to it to be removed in the name of
Jesus.
And I don't got what God says. Because if the enemy knows that he can get you to stop speaking what the word of God says, he got you. See, because he knows that if he puts some things on you, you're going to stop going to church. You're going to stop speaking what the word says. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing comes by the word. That's why it's so good to stay connected, amen, to the body of Christ. Because, amen, faith comes by hearing by the word of God. Amen. So, let us know, amen, that the only way we can achieve our goals is if we keep speaking. Yeah. It ain't happened yet. That's why you keep saying something. You keep speaking, something ain't happened yet. I'm going to keep speaking it. I'm going to keep speaking it. I'm going to keep speaking it. And I'm going to keep speaking it. And I'm going to keep speaking it.
Yes.
Because correct. God has already prepared the way.
That's it. That's
it's
it.
Already here, saints of God.
That's it. Amen.
That's good.
Let me finish reading that 17th verse.
Go ahead.
Okay. So he says, amen, in the second latter part of the verse. He said that it shall, he said, let's read it again. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper in every tongue that shall rise against thee. In judgment thou shalt. Is there righteousness? Somebody say there righteousness.
Yeah, righteousness.
If there righteousness is of me, said the Lord. in the righteousness of God. Amen. Thank you. In the promises of God. Amen. In the word of God. Amen. That he starts, amen, at the very first verse saying that no weapon that's formed against you. He lets us know that the enemy gonna come.
That's it.
But it's not gonna prosper.
That's
somebody
it.
Said not gonna prosper.
Glory.
It's not gonna prosper.
That's
it's
it.
Not gonna prosper. Amen.
Yeah.
So whenever he do come, amen, the only thing that he's gonna come running dead into is what the word says, amen.
Yeah.
The only thing he's gonna run up against is what the word says, amen. That is not gonna prosper.
Amen.
The only way something can prosper is if you start speaking, amen, and start confessing that it's not gonna work. Then you don't give God the opportunity to allow, amen, his spirit to flow freely and to protect you from any and everything that's coming against you. Amen. But he already said it, amen, in his word, amen, that if we stand upon the promises of what God will, I don't care what people say about me, about people that said all kind of things, but you got to realize they only saying some things about you because the devil already see where you're going.
Yeah.
See, the devil already see where you already going. And what he does is that he start making somebody, amen. That's why you got to make your circle smaller. Amen. Because if it's somebody that's around my circle that keeps speaking negative, then you can't walk with me. Come on,
y'all.
If you want to be somebody every time I go around, you saying something negative, then you can't be in my circle. If you want to be a person that settle for less every time I see you, then you can't walk in my circle.
Well,
you can't walk with me.
Right,
it's not that I don't want you to, but it's that you choose to by speaking what you speak. Somebody say, I'm going.
I'm
going somewhere. You ain't got no time, amen, for no negative folks.
No, that's right.
When you walk into your destiny and you gonna get what God has for you, you ain't got time for folks that ain't got no place to walk with you. If I'm gonna believe God for something, I'm not bringing nobody with me. Well, I shall say my wife and I. We're not going to bring somebody with us that ain't leaving God.
Yeah.
If they just every time we look on the phone and yeah, and never settle and leaving God, then you can't walk with us. It's not that I'm more than you are, but I'm walking on the promises of God. Because the latter part of the verse says, and that is their righteousness and their inheritance. Amen. In God. Somebody shout glory in this place. It's already been established in the kingdom already for you to have it.
Amen.
But a lot of folks don't want to go through nothing to get it.
Come on.
The minute somebody starts saying something about them, then they get mad. The minute things ain't going their way, then they start getting mad. You know why? We've got to get rooted and grounded in what the Word says first.
Yes, yes.
See, right. If we get the Word engrafted inside of our heart, that when the enemy comes in like a flood, then what you put in is what's going to stand up for you.
Amen.
Huh? See, what you put in, you got to first put money in your bank to have money in it. If you ain't got no money in the bank and go to make a withdrawal, then you won't be the withdrawal because you ain't put nothing inside.
Preach it, baby, preach.
See, what you got to do, you got to make some deposits. Somebody say make some deposits. You got to make some deposit first before you can make some withdrawals. Putting the Word on the inside.
Yes.
That when you really need it, amen, it's going to show up on the outside. See, once you start putting that Word inside you, amen, that when the enemy comes in, you ain't got to fight for yourself. That when folks start talking, that Word will start rising up on the inside of you. Before they start finishing their conversation, that Word will start dealing with them. Before you even start, find out who said what, the Holy Ghost, the Word of God, when the Word took care. I had a friend of mine went to prison. We was friends. Never knew that he said he was going to whip me and the Holy Ghost. That's what this word. I whip all over you and I whip all over. The man come to my house, left on my door, got out of prison. Said I come to apologize. I said, apologize for what? He said I was gonna whip all over you and all over the Holy Ghost. Now me, of course, bless the Lord. But the Holy Ghost, then you got a problem because guess what? That's you and God. But I told the gentleman, I said, sir, I hold nothing against you. I don't even, God must have closed my ears. I heard nothing he said about what he
did. That's it, Reverend.
But my point of the matter is, God dealt with the man in prison. Y'all ain't gonna help me get in prison. The man was in prison, and God was dealing with him about what he told me, and he was in prison. See, when you come, and I'm not saying he was in prison because of what he said to me. I said he went for some other things, but while he was in there, amen, God began to deal with him.
Yeah.
The point of the matter here, say, man, is that while you are going about your business, the Word that's in you that you deposit on the inside of you is already fighting you. It's already fighting on your behalf, amen. Because the one that talked about you behind your back, talk about your mama and your daughter, how no good your family was, while they sneaking or wherever they at, the Word of God is starting with the devil, amen, and you don't even know nothing about it, amen. I couldn't sleep last night because I was talking about such and such. I couldn't rest yesterday because I put my mouth on this person or that person. But what happened? If we allow the Word of God to work on the inside of us, not only will he fight your battle, but what he'll do, amen, that when you speak some things, being a righteous man or woman of God, amen, it's got to come to pass, amen. Because God has already made the way. We have access to the kingdom, amen. We've got access. That's why a lot of times, amen, when we go somewhere, when you walk in places, when you going there, it's just the favor of God. How do you always get there? Why is all, how do you always? Because favor. God will move on behalf of his people. But the only way he's going to do so, we're getting ready to close, is if you have made a deposit. What do you mean, Pastor? Amen. You've got to get some word on the inside. Amen. See, the only way, man, you're going to be able to take a stand, amen, is that some word.